Dr. Maxine Clark. I wish to take this opportunity on the first morning of the first day of school to extend a warm welcome to all faculty and staff, and a sincere hope that you have returned from the helpful and fruitful summer vacation with renewed vim and vigor, ready to gird your loins and tackle the many important and vital tasks that lie ahead. Undaunted. Thank you for your help and cooperation in the past and future.
Same message every September. I'm E. Schachter. I have room 508. Hope you'll bear it. First time, me. Our Dr. Clark gives us her pros and pairs. Aims and goals, help and encourage, guide and inspire,
new horizons and broader distance.
I'm about to teach my first class.
First ever? You're prepared?
Well, I thought I might begin with first impressions. The importance of appearance and manners on speech, on which I can build a case for good diction, correct usage, and fluent self-expression. From parents, just the stuff.
You're sure you've come to the right school?
Calvin Coolidge High School, room 304.
When I said prepare,
I majored in Middle English Literature, two courses on the philosophy of education, and my master's thesis on Tossing.
Wow. Good luck, Sylvia. If you need anything, just holler. I'm right up there.
Well, thanks, but I...
Better you'd study karate.
Hey, teacher. You're the teacher?
Turn our right. When do we go to lunch? lunch, but if you could all finish your part.
Oh, first name last, last name first.
Last name first.
I can't write upside down.
He just killed me laughing.
Oh, what do you need my address for? My father can't come.
Thank you.
dental, whatever that is.
It's a missing dental. Well, I haven't had your Chinese. So if we can get back to the dentist, I'd really like to.
Time or to report to the office to assist in activities which demand attention. Regarding the requisition of supplies, please anticipate your needs. Do not make excessive demand. Any teachers wishing decorative posters? We have a few left. Block letters, blue on white, knowledge is power. And yellow on green, learning equals earning. Also, brown and tan of Swiss Alps. Slightly torn, but still usable.
Please do not encourage students to purchase paper editions of Shakespeare and other authors. Due to outside pressures, we should not expose them to insufficiently edited or unexpurgated texts.
Samantha Buster, chairman of the English department, a brilliant teacher. So naturally, she's promoted right out of the classroom.
Students delinquent in obtaining athletic suits are to be alphabetized and reported. Girls who wish to be excused from gym are to be sent to me with all pertinent data.
Frances Egan, the school nurse.
Please discourage excessive dieting in your homeroom.
Teachers should function according to instructions. This means hand in on time.
Sadie Walsa, the school clerk.
Pupils are to report back to the homeroom to be checked off at 2:56. Spizzle bell will ring at 3:05 sharp. This, however, is uncertain.
Send legitimate late misses to the late miss coordinator. If excuse is invalid or suspect, send offenders to me. Please read to your students the list of infractions to instill in them a sense of civic responsibility. Post at a prominent place in homeroom. A student who is late may fail to graduate.
Have to leave me now. I'm trying to salvage a potential dropout.
The first girl I called on today was dropping out.
Our friend. Helen.
I gotta drop out, Miss Barrett. I gotta work. I'm of age and my income is needed at home.
Well, Helen, before you drop out, perhaps we could have a talk.
Why talk? Most schools are waste anyhow. Every period, another subject? Algebra, French, Eco, English. What good is it?
Well, if you'd only let me explain, I could really tell you.
All the jumble, and in every class, the teacher tells you something different. So you don't know who to believe.
Helen, before you take this step, it's going to affect your entire
life. Save your breath. I'm better off out.
Mrs. Burke!
Yes, Mrs. McKay?
Has come to my attention that you have neglected to fill out Form B-22 accident report of a fall from a chair incurred by a student in your official class. Such negligence may result in serious consequences.
But Mr. McKay, he wasn't even hurt. And my real concern
before
is—
Before leaving the building today, please make out Form B-22 in triplicate.
Yes, Mr. McKay.
Thank you. You there! Just a minute!
I think you're expecting a little too much, Miss Barrett.
Admiring your penmanship?
My name... It looks so unfamiliar, and I get the funny feeling if I didn't even spell it right.
For a teacher who has ever...
Border racing. Thank you.
But Hank wasn't around, so I took two.
You'll have to do better, Miss Barrett.
Solve keep you. Have a free, unassigned period. I'll be having coffee at the teacher's lounge.
Well, maybe I could join you. I mean, if I can get the locker assignment.
Then I'll see you.
B. Schachter.
I'm a child.
Well, then, great. You haven't told me about Paul Berenger.
The glamour boy of the English department. Unpublished writer. Such men are dangerous. They'll woo you with rhymes. You're on your own.
See.
A moment, Miss Barrett.
Yes, Mr. McKay.
Was Joel Barone in homeroom this morning? Did he stay to the bell?
He was a little late, but he stayed to the bell.
You are certain. It's important. A valuable wallet was stolen from a locker this during homeroom, and I understand that Joe Verone was seen loitering in that vicinity just before the bell.
Well, then it couldn't have been Joe. He was in homeroom.
I see. Was he in any trouble?
Trouble?
Disruptive? Rude? Any trouble?
No trouble.
If you think it helps to cover for them, then you're sadly mistaken.
If there's nothing else for students, I'm going for coffee.
Better luck next time, McCabe.
Mr. McCabe.
Mister.
Every year I deal with a lot just like you.
Please ascertain the number of students who have not had a hot breakfast. Now that winter is approaching, this is particularly important. Poor nutrition is frequently the cause of poor marks.
Well, it's hard to say. For one thing, he waits until
leaving his classroom. I get the feeling it's because he doesn't want to be too touched by the kids. It's like he's just marking time until he's published and can leave.
And you and the girl students find this intriguing.
Devastatingly. There's this one girl in my class, Alice Blake, who's lovesick of a man.
The thing I don't like about him, Miss Harris.
Please, Alice.
He never sits behind his desk. Either he thinks that he has to do or sits on top. And have you ever noticed that one eyebrow is higher than the other?
Alice, the subject is Homer's The Odyssey.
I know. Also the myth and the dream. But have you ever
looking forward to seeing your paper, Alice.
Yes.
Well, have you?
Have I what?
Notice his eyebrows.
The one that's higher than the other? Well, what possible difference can... I can't finish now. I hear Paul coming.
I'll send the rest of this letter tomorrow.
What's the matter with Alice Blake?
There's nothing the matter with Alice Blake.
Don't bite my head off. Especially now. Because you're about to be immortalized. I found something that rhymes with Sylvia Barrett.
There's nothing that rhymes with Barrett.
14 carats. Why did you insist on leaving so early last night? I thought we were having a pretty good time.
Well, paper's fine.
No one can take it that seriously. You were put off by my bad mood. What was the latest rejection slip? The tone was not only polite, but patronizing. Why don't I write it something familiar?
Well?
What do they want me to write about? Calvin Coolidge High School?
At least they couldn't say you're not familiar with.
Kids sprawling in classrooms, yawning in the subways, pushing through the halls.
That's only the surface, Paul. If you'd only get closer.
Until you get closer?
Trying. But I haven't even figured out what to call them yet. Students, youngsters, teenagers, young adults. And all seem so stilted and odd, even offensive.
Let me know my pupil love. Sylvia, I've started on a new novel. This one's gonna make it. Let's have a cup of coffee later and I'll tell you about it.
Sure.
A big subject. A nuclear physicist, Peru, on a peninsula in Kamchatka.
I looked up Kamchatka. It's at the far east end of Russia, opposite Japan.
Well, maybe he knows all about it, sister. Maybe he reached Calvin Coolidge High School via the Trans-Siberian Railroad.
Not likely, but somewhere.
Are you reaching the students?
No. But we had a beautiful moment yesterday. I put on the board, Brownings, a man's reach should exceed his grasp for what's heaven for. And then we were involved. A spirited discussion. Aspiration versus reality. A class, is it wise to aim higher than one's capacity?
No. Not too high.
And does it doom one to failure?
Your class in order?
They are in order. I mean, we're in order.
Then what is the meaning of this?
The meaning of what?
All this noise?
The noise, Mr. McKay? That's the sound of thinking.
There'll be a series of three bells rung three times indicating shelter drill. Loud discussions do not encourage the orderly evacuation of the class.
Cozy has his problems too.
Yes, but keeping order is getting to be the important thing. Enthusiasm is frowned upon because it gets so noisy. Maybe other teachers are more successful.
Maybe let it be a challenge to you.
So far?
During my many years of frequent school, I am well satisfied.
too early to tell.
Edward.
Edward Williams, Esquire. All tears flunk me because I'm poor. Frankly, I ran out of tears, so I'm no good at English rather than give me dirt looks in the hall.
What a dirty English is dumb. It's such a hard subject. I spend so much time doing it.
Essay is a bunch of gossip. I'm in most of the birds. George Eliot stinks. Even though he's a lady.
A kaleidoscope. A crazy quill. Ever shifting pattern. Shapes that come and go, leaving no effort behind. Such as none of them have lost the man's hours of anger from whence I arrived. All creativity stifled. There are phoenix to hope and joy. Will it be different this term? The question. Poison. I was supposed to be in this chapter for the writing class, but it was a little conflict. I couldn't get it.
I see. Well, let me ask a specific question. Why do we study myths, like the Odyssey?
Because we want to sound like culture and people. At a party, how would you like if someone mentioned a Greek god and you didn't know him? You'd be embarrassed.
Look at this French. Free education, I still get hard assignments.
We've learned about this. We see what it looks like to live in the Golden Age with all the children.
If it wasn't for myths, where was Shakespeare going to be? He studied myths because they're about love.
To me, the Odyssey was just another Ethan Frome from Silas Marner. Who wants to hear about someone's troubles?
Everyone has to read them. It's our turn now.
Help us gain tolerance for others.
Read it.
Read it? Because it's a classical.
My opinion, I hate the Odyssey. Homer's a lousy writer.
What are you trying to prove?
No one at this school cares about us. And it's the same at home and in the streets outside. You probably don't care for my language, so give me a zero vocabulary. Anyhow, I'm quitting the end of this term. Join the dogs eating dogs in the lousy world you're educating us for. Oh, but don't worry. You'll still find plenty of willing to play your game of Ba Ba Little Lamb, trot and step and get your nice clean diplomas served on dirt. Yummy. I trust that answers your question.
You express yourself vividly, Joe. Your metaphors, from dogs to lambs, are apt. I think I'd give you higher credit than you'd give yourself. Joe, before you drop out, perhaps we can have a talk. There's so much I wish I could convey.
I don't understand the big words. And I'm busy after school. Every day. You're gonna have to prove yourself on your own time, Teach.
Alright then.
It's lost everywhere.
It's like this.
went. Oh, my.
I guess that makes it unanimous.
Now, thank you.
Not quite unanimous.
Now, please don't open the test booklets until I tell you.
Why can't the test teach?
I learned your name, Kara. Why can't you learn mine?
Why do we do formals?
Because it's protocol, Tom. Right, Miss Barry?
You're a teach. Why not call you a teach?
Alice, this doesn't seem to be friendly.
Back in a few minutes. I'm just using the laboratory.
There's no hall proctor.
So what are you gonna do?
I'm gonna trust you. Do I have your word you won't cheat or look up answers?
Sure do, Teach.
But does showing disrespect make you feel better, Joe? The more important, the bigger man?
It makes me get out of here.
Please do your work and, Charles, right? Do your own paper. Right-handed, not left-handed. Shouldn't have let go. But you can't take the system so seriously. I mean, have you seen some of these? Lateness due to absence? Totally open consent slips. High underachiever.
I can match yours any day.
Please disregard the following. All teachers, at the end of COVID, please send students who have failed to report for checkup because they've left the building to Mr. McCabe.
How do we send students who left the building?
It'll be a challenge.
Miss
Garrett.
Yes, Miss Messner?
I plan on observing your class soon.
See. Miss Messner.
Yes?
The book group says they only have 7 copies of Romeo and Juliet.
Oh, we'll use Ivanhoe. They have 160 copies of Ivanhoe.
Linda, your test.
Care? Just who do you think you're kidding?
Is there something else to show?
No. Nothing else. It's too bad I can't believe you. That's all.
Outside.
What caution?
I don't know. know. Something's going on. Miss Barry, have you seen Mr. Granger? He's wanted right away.
No, I'm afraid he's just left.
Where to?
No idea.
If he comes back, tell him what office. Immediately.
But I don't plan on seeing him any time soon. A license in English in the New York City Secondary School District, and I'm present teaching at home.
Please send down the health car for Alice Blake. Urgent. Do you have any blank accident reports? I'm all out. Urgent.
No, I don't. What accident? What's happened?
All teachers and students are to remain in their rooms disregarding the bell until further notice. Lessons are to resume as usual, no reference to the incident. Teachers are to discourage morbid curiosity.
But Mr. McCabe, what incident? What's happened?
Such atypical behavior is completely unnormal for a girl with such a stable personality profile. But I guess there are factors beyond our control.
The office told you to call the emergency board.
What?
All you do is check on your guardian reach.
Very well qualified.
your lesson. You always manage to make it interesting. Signed, Charles K.
Clean up the slum before you go to Mars, and stop the bomb before it's too late. As far as school, without us, there is no school or futures. Signed, Lou Martin.
Would you please tell Lou Martin to stop showing off? He thinks he's such a comic. Well, I don't. Signed, Serious Student.
Don't worry, Ms. Bear. We're behind you 65%.
Thank you for showing me that there is nothing more important than communication. But with so many other students, I feel that we are both good. Your friend, Carol.
I'm not a good writer. But others I want to know. I'm putting this in the suggestion box for a rapper. My birthday. Happy birthday. Don't me.
Have you written something really, again?
A parody of Ezra Pound, which I plan to lay at the feet of our dedicated colleague. Is Sylvia back yet?
Yes.
Where is she?
I haven't spoken to her.
I'm the villain. What would you do if you received a love letter from a student?
I've no idea.
Is Sylvia back? I have a problem with Alice Blake. She still is in Sylvia's official class.
What's the problem?
An overdue book. The old library for your sense.
What book?
The Idols of the King, Oscar Lloyd.
Could always send a posse to the hospital.
Feeling is bold, but this is a matter of record. And that's the first time I had to worry constantly about overdue books.
Well, doesn't it get you a little excited that a student cares to read?
You sound like Sylvia. I used to get excited. There was no help, no books, and constant demands. All I care about now is the term 5 years to survive.
And right now you need 49 cents.
Right now, I'm called trying to make the rules I do.
I wish it were that
easy. I may never your teachers promise to do it. Getting involved has done no good. So keep waiting. When you have to catch me instead, that's the only way to remain intact.
I'm not sure it's possible to teach and remain intact.
Make up your mind.
As Ella Friedenberg would say, I have a problem.
But you're working on it.
All I really care about is maintaining my abused attachment.
Come off it, Paul.
Oh, Sylvia! I've written another parody for you. Gray's Elegy. The school bell tolls the knell of starting day. Ah, do not ask for whom it tolls. I see the students' stairwards push their screaming way. I know at last it tolls for E and me.
That's very
I have some other ones, also very clever. When I didn't see you yesterday, I was afraid you left us. But I'm glad you
I think he's a lot more upset than he shows.
Maybe. You know, I couldn't even talk to Alice at the hospital. She wasn't having visitors.
That's what I heard.
Sylvia. Why have you neglected to send in the teacher today?
Because Linda Rosen wore a pink sweatshirt and future stretch pants to school today. She was seen by Mr. McKay, who had a cooler heels than the office. She was also seen by the boys in my class, who migrated en masse from her vicinity. I'll take attendance later. Unless, of course, they follow her like lemmings into the sea and all around.
Poor Mr. McKay.
She only had one thing to say about Alice's accident. Turn in before 3, mock assignments and book receipts for Blake, Alice. McKay reminds us to keep our public image intact and our students in their seats. Dr. Clark reminds us of our responsibility to democracy.
What else can they say?
I don't know, something that proves that they care about the girl. Our
are we teaching? Is anything getting through, or are we just talking to ourselves?
You were missed yesterday. And to go down and rescue your substitute, your kids were turning her into a nervous wreck.
Why would they do that?
Misguided loyalty.
To me? You wouldn't believe the lesson anyways. She was having them turn great poems into newspaper headlines. Such as,
they might write our words of love, seen them guilty of shooting bird.
Wife sells all of Portuguese love letters?
Not bad. Matterport's talking raven.
Maybe I should have stayed away.
Where were you?
I get the feeling my end-term rating is gonna be a big, fat U.
No one is rated unsatisfactory. I'm a certified loony.
That's not entirely true, Ms. Schachter. Regarding your requisition, Ms. Baird, we are all out of erasers, all out of red pencils. Our order for window poles have been sent to the board last spring. We have to be patient. There's been an epidemic of chalk stealing lately, so please keep chalk under lock except when in use. However, we have some leftover posters. Blue on white, knowledge is power. And yellow on green, learning equals earning.
Mr. McCabe, what I really need
is... We have to be patient. One thing more, a frivolous attitude and levity of tone towards attendance taking are unsuitable to the high seriousness of our profession.
We try to cut down on levity, Mr. McCabe. Have you, by any chance, left time yet to go over Joe Ferron's examination paper?
Yes, I did. So did Miss Bester.
And?
His mark was 86.
Any evidence of cheating?
You have heard.
No evidence of cheating?
That's right.
Well, then shouldn't something be said? If not to me, then at least to Joe Thoreau.
Why?
I'm hoping he'll stay in school.
He should not have been let out the room unescorted. He knew it, you knew it, the fact that he didn't cheat.
Should be noted.
To what purpose?
No one must feel unsatisfactory.
If you're concerned about getting a U, then you're...
I'm concerned about so many things, okay?
And you think you can handle the Joe Thoreau? You try running the school for one day, and you'll have a riot in every room.
All I'm saying is some strong things were said, and now that we know that he did well, didn't you?
This time.
I'm hoping there will be a next time.
We'll always have more than we can handle. We have to be realistic. You weren't here yesterday.
Spent the day at Willowdale Academy being interviewed for a possible February job.
I see.
It's being realistic.
Yes. Of course.
You upset him.
McCabe.
He's upset.
Not McCabe. Never.
Sylvia, I don't find him inspirational either. But remember, his pupil load is 3,000.
You know, it's such a different world at William.
You mean nobody shouts hi to each?
Mean I only have to teach 3 classes a day, 3 days a week. The other 2 are for seminars. I may even be able to hold a conference on Chaucer.
If that's what you want.
What I want is to be able to practice my profession. I want to be like Chaucer's clerk of Oxford. And gladly would he learn it, gladly teach.
Sylvia, why do you think your kids picked on the substitute yesterday?
Ask McCabe.
Ask yourself.
B, did anything else happen while I was gone?
Life was happening.
Don't worry, Miss Barrett, we're behind you 85%.
My mother has been living with me for 16 years, but she still insists on cross-examining. Would you please talk to her? Signed, Linda.
I know the school is supposed to help you with life, but so far it didn't.
Tell us more about your life. It makes you seem more...
ever met. You make classes enjoyable and laughable. Boom Larson.
Thank you for showing me that writing ability.
One reason why I should stay in school. Signed, Joe Farrell.
Well, I can give you many good reasons.
To take what McCabe dishes out?
Joe, about our job. If you could come in sometime, I could really explain.
Why do you care? What's in it for you?
Frankly, I'm beginning to wonder. For now, let's just say it's my job.
If I didn't know better, you'd even convince me. Save it for the shame.
Joe, about our talk.
Miss Barrett. I'm slipping this into your suggestion box with the most likely place to catch your attention.
I see.
There's a rumor going on that you're leaving at the end of the term. Why on earth would you leave?
Let's just say I can find the proper response to I teach.
I wish you would reconsider.
Why?
Because if you left us, where else would I get such ghastly, honest literary criticism?
Sure you want criticism?
No. But just the same, you're needed here. You're our spokesperson, our infighter, our catalyst. Besides, you laugh a bit, like an English teacher should. And I'm not saying this to get a higher mark. Signed, Paul.
Blazing a trail versus
conformity, and their regret in erring in any decision.
Certainly, Africa.
Ms. Vester?
My comments follow. Ask your question first, and then call on the student by name. Thus, you engage the whole class in thinking. Avoid vague or loaded questions. How do you feel about this poem? Vague. Do we regret what we haven't done? The teacher obviously expects yes.
Indeed.
The boy next to me was doing his math. A teacher should move about the room. Immediate correction of English was effective. Oh, but you missed. He should have took the room on this hero, and he couldn't make up his mind.
He couldn't.
I like the way you handled the hostile boy who came late, the one with the toothpick in his mouth. You made him feel as though the class had missed his contribution, but you should have made him remove the toothpick.
I've been fighting a losing battle with that toothpick all term.
Who wouldn't? And don't let a few students monopolize the discussion. Call on the non-volunteers. I'm not sure you're putting your energy where it's most needed.
I see.
The cream will probably rise to the top anyway. Where are our homes most students here? Is with the skim milk.
I appreciate your principle, Miss
The lesson I observed was a fruitful discussion of choices. But what really concerns me is your choice. But I see you have a class. My formal report will follow.
If you could all sit down, please. We're going to start Macbeth today.
Ambition. Lead to troubles. Well, let's think.
That
lit up by the witches. All the trouble they take them on. Bottles, bubbles, all the troubles. I hate that stuff.
The bell, Joe. School's out.
I heard.
Is there something?
Well, you keep saying that you want me to stay for a talk. So, I stayed. How about that?
I see.
So, what do you want to talk about? Let's go. Let's have it.
I've been looking over your record, Joe, and I'm struck by the discrepancy between your capacities
and your... I'm sorry, could you please put that
English.
In...
How about, I can't understand the big words, Siege. You could rock on your heels. You could drop your boots.
Okay.
This is important, Joe, to both of us.
My discrepancies?
Your capacity.
Why do you care so much? What's in it for you?
I do.
That's what you told me before.
Joe, listen. Really, what I need to say
is... Are you listening?
I'm trying.
Are you coming back next term?
Joe.
That's a straight question.
Then I'd have to say no.
No what?
No, I'm not coming back next term.
No. You're not coming back. Well, thanks anyway.
But Joe, just because I'm not coming back next time doesn't mean that you can't.
We finished our talk, Miss Barrett. What makes you think you're so special?
Says that when I turn 17, why should you feed another mouth? That's me. Well, what I'm trying to say, Miss Barrett, is I hope I can come back next year.
She was silent for
you shall.
Miss Barrett! What makes you think you're so special? Do you know what I'm trying to say? Or, no, what I mean is, what I'm trying to say is that you're so special. You're my teacher. So teach me. Help me. Hey, teach, which way do I go? I'm tired of going up and down the staircase.
Please. This is your principal, Dr. Maxine Clark, and I wish to take this opportunity on the first morning of the first day of the February term to extend a warm welcome to all faculty and staff, and with a sincere and earnest hope we can go forward and upward together.
Why are you?
I'm talking about Miss Barrett.
Charles.
Why are you talking about
Miss Barrett?
She's
looking at
all
the books.
Well, you probably heard me. But I'm back! I'm behind you 95%, Miss Barrett!